According to figures presented by the National Coffee Research Institute, only 5% of the total population of Uganda consumes coffee products locally. Experts say there is need to increase it to 15% by the end of 2023. Dr. Geoffrey Arinaitwe, the director of the National Coffee Research Institute, says value addition is the only way to achieve this. Arinaitwe adds that the project will further enable a farmer to realize more profits as opposed to selling green beans as raw materials.
A project that is under a validation program. The project is intended in the long term to increase value-added products for export and generating income with stabilizing prices on farm level. This project is in line with the National Development Plan 3, NDP3, and NDP3 has a program for agro-industrialization, and under agro-industrialization program, the country expects to increase commercialization, industrialization with increased domestic consumption.
He noted that competition in the world market is very stiff, and Ugandan coffee, which is exported as green beans, cannot survive.
If many people drank coffee or utilize coffee, at least the farmer will have multiple ways of trading his coffee after harvesting. And like this project is intending to, if we use small beans that are not usually traded in the classical market to produce cosmetics, from 1 kilogram, probably the farmer will realize more value than the value arises when he sells 1 kilogram.
Dr. Godfrey Kagezi, the principal research officer at the National Coffee Research Institute, says the project is under the competitive grant scheme, which will look at major challenges affecting coffee farmers, such as coffee wilt disease.
We are looking at the planting materials. Farmers, planting materials is quite a planting materials is one of the biggest problems they have. So our project is carrying out the planting materials which are resistant to the coffee disease. Coffee disease is one of the diseases which almost finished 50% of our Robusta coffee in Uganda in the 90s and 2000s. We are also looking at how to manage these pests and diseases, and we are also looking at cost-effective, farmer-friendly technologies for drying our coffee.
However, Abasaru Baromba, the chairperson of Banyankore Kwetarana Cooperative Union, complained of traders who hoodwink farmers by buying their coffee while it is still at flowering stage.
The issue of traders going to the field, they normally go to the field and visit our farmers. They give them loans, and you find a farmer is selling flowers, not even harvesting, and then you supply the ready product. So we are having that challenge in the sense that they normally visit our farmers, they give them money, and the farmer is losing a lot, and at the end of it all, it even affects the quality of the coffee that is going to the market. Nationwide, we are trying to improve the quality of coffee, but because of these farmers, you know, they don't have enough funds. They are looking for money to pay for their school fees. When this businessman comes with the money, he normally gives them the funds, and he buys the garden instead of buying the product. So this is a very big challenge, and our farmers are losing a lot. We would like to request them at least be patient and harvest their coffee so that they get more income for their households.
According to the National Coffee Research Institute, Uganda stands at 8th position in coffee production in the world. By the end of 2023, they want to be the 6th to overtake Honduras and India. Report compiled by Adolf Ayoreka for the news.